Hi everyone. Okay, welcome back. We will start in about 3 minutes time. So please do share and like our page during this time. Make sure you get your friends to join us for our session later. We're making the witch's broom. Okay, so please do share the page and like our page. We'll start in 3 minutes. Go and share, go and like.
Yeah.
Share with your part.
I'm sure.
Let's see who's, who has joined us so far. Mute.
Sorry.
It's okay. I'm okay. Okay, later we're making this. All right, Opa. What's the time? 1:09. Okay, we'll start in about another minute or so. I'll teach you what to do.
You teach me, but don't expect I can make exactly what you teach.
Oh, this is beginners. Don't worry. Yeah.
Really?
Yes. Okay. Kind of. Today might be a little bit more difficult than usual.
Well, today is my first time fire.
It's okay. Okay. I'm here to help you. But if you're on your own at home, it might be. I'll try not to.
A lot of teacher.
Oh, I will practice my patience.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I like teaching a very, very young kid.
Teaching a very young kid. That's so. Okay.
Sorry, it looks like a very beer.
Oh, you don't have the mic. I only have. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to begin. Can hear me, right? Okay. Yep. So welcome back, everyone. My name is Annabelle. Okay. Thank you for joining me today. I'm in the loft. I'm not at home, so the background is a little bit different.
Yeah.
You can tell they decorated it very nicely for the month of November. It looks like because it's Deepavali in November, right? So the decoration is Deepavali. It's very pretty. And then today I have a guest. So Opa is going to join me.
Hello.
Can everyone hear him? Is he loud enough? Louder, yes. Okay. And today we're going to make the witch's broom. So for the past few weeks, because it's been Halloween, I have been making quite a few Halloween-themed projects. So if you can tell, I'm wearing my pumpkin earrings today. And then I tie the witch's hat on my hair. Opa showed me it looked very cute. He's just agreeing only. Thank you, Opa. Okay, so today I'll teach you how to make the witch's broom. Okay, so it can be used for two things. You can either use it as decoration and then just display it in the house, or you can make it into a necklace. So I'll show you how to make it into a necklace, all right? Okay, so Opa is going to help me today. He's probably going to make the decorative one because he's probably not going to wear a necklace with a witch's broom on it.
Yeah.
Okay. So I like this project because this is quite good to do with the kids. It's a little bit more difficult than the usual but it shouldn't be too tough. All right. So the making is quite easy. It's just that there's a little bit more steps. The things that we need today, okay, it's very, very simple. You just need these two clay. Okay, you need gold and you need brown. That's it. All right. If you want some variation in the brown, right, I have a bit of scrap brown color. So I mix my dark brown and light brown together. So there's a bit of color variation, a bit of marbling. Okay, so you can get that too. You can add a bit of black to create the marbling as well. All right. So, but these are the two main colors that you need today. And then you'll need the eye pin if you're making necklace. So this is the eye pin. Yes, if you're making necklace, okay? So this is eye pin, okay, Opa?
Okay.
Okay, but Opa is not making necklace today.
Oh, too difficult for me.
Yes. No, it's not difficult. But I cannot imagine you wearing a witch's broom necklace. So for guys, if you don't want to make necklace, it's fine. You can make something that is decorative also.
Mm.
Yeah. Okay, so we can start. Okay, so we will take the brown first, this one. This one is chocolate. Okay, the color is called chocolate. So you can buy it from Art Friend. That's what I did. Plaza Sing or Bras Basah Complex. Okay, so we are just going to cut about 1/8 of it. So you can see here, there are already lines on the clay itself already. So this is 1/4. Those lines are all about 1/4. So Opa, squeeze into a ball. Okay. Yes.
Very soft.
Yes, very soft, right?
Very soft. Actually, this one very soft, much softer than I expected. This one, well, more softer than chewing gum.
Chewing gum?
Yeah, when you were young, then you can play with the chewing gum, right?
What a way to describe it.
Yeah.
Oh, chewing
Sorry,
gum.
Here is a Singapore, so that is it.
I'm sure people have chewed chewing gum before, but it's a very interesting way to use to describe.
Oh, yeah, anyway, yeah. If you already, when you play with the chewing gum, you can understand what I'm talking about.
I would describe it more like Play-Doh.
I never play with the Play-Doh.
Ah, Korea doesn't have Play-Doh?
When I was young,
I didn't have really? Oh my gosh, Play-Doh is like the best thing. Okay, have you rolled into a ball already?
I rolled. Okay,
so those that are following us at home, you also try and follow along and do the same thing. If I'm going too fast, right, let me know. Then you can type in the comments if you have any questions, and I'll answer them along the way also.
Is this correct? Mine is correct?
Yes, just any rough ball will do. This is correct.
Okay,
next, right, we are going to roll it on the table like this. Use your hand, and then you roll. We are going to make this part of the witch's broom now.
Oh.
Okay, we're going to make this part. So the broomstick.
Okay.
I think your broomstick is a bit too fat.
Yours is also fat.
I haven't finished rolling yet. You roll until the correct thickness you want.
As thick as like this, right?
Yes. If you need like a good example in front of you, right? You can do you can Google online for like witch's broom to get a picture. Mine, if it looks familiar to you, is actually the Harry Potter broom.
The
Nimbus 2000. I googled that. Okay, this is the Harry Potter broom that I googled. So I just googled the picture and then I kind of copied. So I will try. Today the broom that I'm teaching you all is the Nimbus 2000. All right. Okay. So when we're rolling this, you roll to the thickness that you want. Opa, how come you're using the toothpick?
Something particles at the...
On the clay itself. Okay, so this is why you must make sure your countertop that you're working on is clean as well. If not, it will get stuck to the clay. And then, like Opa, he has to take a toothpick to kind of pick it out. Okay? Oh, hello, Tommy. Hello, Shi Yun. Thanks for joining. Okay, mine's about the thickness I want. So because it's necklace, right? The pendant, it can be a bit bigger. If you're making earrings, it's going to be a lot harder. I wouldn't recommend earrings also for we just room for this particular one, because if it's too thin, right, this broomstick here can snap. So for earrings, it won't be very sturdy. So I wouldn't recommend it for earrings.
How's mine? Is it?
Are you happy with the thing? Because yours is going to be display. I think this for display is okay. For display, if it's a bit bigger, it's fine. It doesn't have to be too small. Okay. Yeah. For pendant, like, it will be a bit on the smaller side.
Okay.
You're happy with that?
Oh.
Okay. Then we are going to use the cutter. You have a cutter in front of you.
Oh, yeah.
This is the cutter. Okay. This is the cutter. We are going to use the cutter and we are going to cut. Okay. We are going to cut to the length that we want. So, Opal, how long do you want your broom to be? You cut it to according to how long you want it to be. If it's a bit longer, it's okay, don't worry.
About 10 centimeters.
Oh, that's fine. You can have a long broom. Okay, the rest of it we don't need anymore. We can just put aside, all right?
Okay.
Okay.
Looks like a worm.
It looks like poop. Sorry. I'm sorry, the way you called it.
I'm so sorry. To describe as much as I can. Yeah.
Nicely, right? I'm sorry, yeah. My one not very nice.
Honestly, it looks like poop.
Okay. Okay, so we don't need the cutter anymore. You can put down. All right. So for now, right, the broomstick, if you can see here, this witch's broom here, okay, the end, we are going to try and sculpt it and then make it like that. Okay, so we are going to do this. So I'm going to teach you, okay, Opa. So one end, you take your index finger, you kind of flatten it.
Uh-huh.
Then the other left, your left hand, if you're right-handed, then it's the opposite way, okay? But I'm right-handed, so I take my index finger and press. My left hand, index finger and thumb, I'm holding this end.
Uh-huh.
Just to hold it in place. Don't press too hard or else you'll flatten. Okay, so you kind of just, you're kind of actually following. And sculpt. Opa's trying his best. Yes. Then you put the table. This really step by step. Then you kind of flatten. Little bit. Don't press too hard. Like you say, the clay quite soft. Okay. Then you use your index finger again. And then you just round it again. Can? Okay. Those at home, you all try and follow along also. Okay. Hi, Weilun. Weilun, say hi to you too, Opa.
Oh, hello, Weilun.
I think you're more popular than
Tommy
me.
Tommy's always to me, Hong. Feel for me, Opa. Yeah,
Opa. You feel great because people call you Opa.
Yeah, also parents in law sometimes call me Opa.
Which is also wrong also. Okay. So this end, you see, I sharpen the tip, right? So what I did is I took my index finger and my thumb, okay, and then I just kind of pinch the end a little bit like that to create this like angle, okay. So that is to create this angle here. I use my index finger and thumb and kind of pinch it this way, so it create this like V shape. Opa, can you try?
Sure.
Opa's trying his best.
Peace.
Yes, very good. Okay, then the nice thing about witch's broom is the broomstick is not always like all very nicely like even shape.
That's straight.
Yeah, it's not straight. This is a bit crooked. So we can make it crooked. So it's quite forgiving when you do this, okay? So we are going to leave about one third of it, the top one third where you flatten the handle. Okay, we leave it straight. And then after that, we're going to put a little bend after about one third. You leave one third, then you put a little bend here, and then straight again.
One third?
That's halfway, Opa. Oh, two thirds. I'm so sorry.
Okay. One third.
Are you happy with that?
Oh.
Let me see. Yeah, so this Opa's one, he's doing well. Okay, so we have some marks, like Opa has some nail marks, right? On the thing, don't worry. Okay, you just take your finger and then you kind of go over the nail marks a little and then it'll go away. Okay, so you can do that. And that's Opa-san. Okay, so Opa-san is a clay piece, so he will just leave it as it is. For mine, it's going to be a necklace. So I take toothpick or satay stick, whichever you want. Okay, and then you just poke it. The part where you flatten the top part of the handle, right? You just poke a hole into it. And then you just put the toothpick through it. Okay? Fast playing with it again. Okay, so then this is the extra step part now. I am going to bake. Okay? So we are going to bake. Opa is going to walk over. Okay, we're going to bake this. Okay. We're going to bake it for maybe about 2 minutes. This is a smaller toaster. The one that I use at home is a bigger oven. Okay, so the bigger oven, right, we will bake it for 10 minutes. You set it at about 100. That's a small toaster. Okay, so you set it at low, and then you
150 or
low. Some of the small toasters don't have temperature.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you set it at low or low medium in between because it's small, very hot, very fast. You put for about 3 minutes, 2 to 3 minutes. First. Don't need it fully baked. You just need it half only. Okay, so you just dip. Okay. Okay. Yes. Okay. So you watch it, make sure it doesn't burn. We are going off room. So while you're waiting for that to bake, there are still other things to do. Okay. We are going to make the brush part of the broom. You call it the brush? Oh, okay. Okay. So for the brush part, what I did was I mixed this chocolate color, right, with some darker brown. It's actually leftover brown that I had from previous project. Then I just mix it together because if you look at the broomstick, the wood color is always like there's different shades of brown. It's not just one color. So it's nice if you create some marbling to it, okay? If you don't have this, if you don't have a darker brown, that's fine, just use black. And then you kind of mix the black with the chocolate brown, okay? But you don't mix it until it becomes one color. You just mix it until there's like, it's like a marble effect, okay? Then we can use that. So, Opa, you're going to, yours is the bigger one. So I'm going to give you more because yours is bigger,
okay?
So depending on the size of your broomstick, you will of course use the brush and make the brush accordingly to the size that you want. So Opa, yours is bigger. So make it soft. This one right now is a bit hard. So you want to knead it a bit.
Okay.
To make it softer.
Oh.
Okay. So mine will be the smaller one. I think I gave you too much. Okay, this will be the base, all right? So it doesn't really matter what color. We will cover it with some other things again later, okay? So this is kind of the base. We're making the base of it first. So we're going to roll it into a round ball. Okay, then make it like oval shape. Oh, it dings. Is it very hot? Careful. I have my helpers at the background, thank you. But please be very careful. Will it burn the top table? No? Thank you very much. Please be careful. Don't burn yourself. Okay, you once yours is done, right, you just let it cool because it's a bit hot. So we will leave it first. Now we're making the brush part.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I realized that I molded mine without telling you what to do. Make it into an oval shape, then you use your index finger and thumb.
Oh.
And then you press the base of it, then it'll become sharp.
Oh.
How is it? Then you can make so it looks like that.
Oh, this one looks like a moon-shaped rice cake.
Moon-shaped rice cake? There's moon-shaped rice cake?
During Mid-Autumn Festival, Koreans are enjoying rice cake like a
oh, crescent. Songpyeon.
Songpyeon.
Okay, so it should look something like that. Very rough. Oppa look like that. Okay, I'm going to help you, okay? So, Oppa, right? What Oppa did? He pressed too much at the end. That's why it can't look like that. So, right, if it looks like that, right, you take your palm, you round it out like that, it will start to look flatter.
Oh.
Okay? So you just do that a bit and then you'll start to, the shape will look a bit better.
Oh.
Okay. So I think this end for him looks nicer. All right. So this will be the brush part. This end, you just press down with your index finger like that.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. Okay. You just press it down until it becomes round like this. Yeah. See, when I press mine, it becomes round like this.
Like so a little bit. Shape?
Yes. It's a bit like a teardrop shape, but you can curve it to one side. For Witcher's Broom, you can make a curve like that. How's Opa doing?
I think it's good.
Okay.
Is good. It good?
Yes, it's better. Okay. Then you round it like that. Ta-da! Opa's one is good also. Okay.
Oh.
So now I have a toothpick in front of you. You take this toothpick, Opa.
There.
Okay. I'll show you what to do. Okay, the round end, right? You poke a hole in the middle with the toothpick. So like that, you poke a hole in the middle. Okay, don't poke it too deep. Just poke it. And then you do this. You start using it, using the toothpick to make a bigger hole like that. Yes. Okay, we have to make it as big because the end of that broomstick is going to go in here.
Ah, I see.
All right. So it's going to be a bigger hole like that.
Okay.
Okay, done?
Done.
Done, good. Okay.
Looks like olive.
Looks like olive? Yes. Actually he's right. This does look a bit like olive. Okay. So this is done. Now we're going to, since we have a lot of this brown, let's use this brown. A bit of that. I think you need a bit more.
Okay.
Okay. Just, what we're going to do, just roll a small ball. This one can put down one side first.
Okay. A little bit bigger than my pinky tip.
Yeah, about your nail. It's the size of your pinky nail. Mm. Okay. It's a very small round ball. This is going to be the top part here of the broom. So just now we made the bottom part this one. So now we're going to make this top part here. So that's what we're making.
Okay.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So it's round. Use your finger, do this.
Okay.
Roll it into a long column. Not long, but okay, about finger width. All right.
Okay.
Okay. Press it flat.
Flat.
Yes. So it has to be long enough to wrap around your broomstick.
Oh, okay.
Okay, Opa's making it longer.
Right, okay.
Okay, it has to be long enough.
Uh-huh.
So you have kind of a long rectangular thing that wraps around. So this will wrap around the top here like that. Okay? So we shall see how hot. Okay, never mind. Never mind. We'll leave it. I think it's still too hot. We'll let it cool a bit more.
Okay.
Now, we are going to make, you see all this brush, like this little brush thing here, the individual ones, right? We are going to make that. So, we're going to help each other.
There.
Okay, you take a small bit of your marble round, and then you're just
Mine is much bigger than yours.
Take a small bit, Opa. I have a big one. You just take a small bit, pinch a small piece. Pinch a small piece. Pinch a small piece. Yes. And then you're just going to roll this way.
Mm.
Okay, we're going to make thin strings.
Thin strings.
Yes, thin strings. Use your palm, roll. Roll thin strings this way. Okay, so we're going to have some thin strips. This will take some time to do. Fast trying his best. So far,
yeah,
come.
When I'm talking without speaking, yeah, speechless, I'm very concentrated.
Yeah, he's trying very hard to concentrate now.
Do not disturb.
Do not disturb. If you have any questions, please ask, okay? Those that are joining us from home, if you have any questions on what you need to do, please ask also. Today, I'm having a house party. We're having a house party, right, Opa?
Oh, yeah, correct. Also, theme is Halloween.
Yes. So, I decorated the house at home.
Oh no,
for
I
some
broke
Halloween.
It.
Never mind, it's okay if you break it, it's okay.
Belun said already looks like a Nimbus 2000.
Oh, really?
Mm.
Yay! Actually, if you really want to make it authentic, right, you can like paint the Nimbus 2000 here, but this one doesn't have. Because I don't know if there's a copy copyright issue or not. But if you have like a gold pen, like a thin one, you can write like Nimbus 2000. That's what they did on Harry Potter.
Yeah.
Come, Opa, we have to roll lots of these strings.
Oh.
We have to roll a lot because we have to cover the whole broom.
Arrasta.
And your broom is big.
Arrasta.
Okay, so make sure you have enough to roll all these thin. Okay, if your thin strings, right, it's not too even, like some parts of it are fat, some parts of it are thin, it does not matter. Okay, because like twigs like that, it's not very even. Okay, so this is what we are creating. It doesn't matter whether it's thick or thin. Okay, so we are just rolling it out. It's easiest to just use the palm of your hands and roll in one direction. Last time I was teaching. Okay, mine broke. Okay, if it starts breaking, that means we're using too much force. Be gentler.
Okay.
Okay. Sometimes I just use my finger to roll it up.
Don't have to be even, right?
Oh no, it doesn't have to be even because this is supposed to like simulate like how like twigs will look like. So this is it doesn't have to be even. This was the leftover cake. Do you remember there was a project I made with my cake?
Chocolate.
The chocolate mousse cake, right? This was the leftover from the chocolate mousse cake. So yeah.
You can make from the scratch.
You can make from scratch, okay, if you don't have leftover, but because for those that do a lot of polymer clay, if you have leftover clay, right, then you can take it from your other project, the leftover clay from those projects and then use it. So it doesn't have to be for this one, you don't need like the solid color, like a proper solid brown. Okay, you can just make it any. It is a few shades of different brown, so you just make it however you want to do it. Continue, Opa, don't stop.
Not enough?
Ania, not enough.
Okay.
This is how we speak at home. I speak very broken Korean. Broken Korean, half Korean, half English. Was it Konglish?
Konglish.
Yeah. It's like Singlish, but Konglish is Korean English. That's Konglish.
Yeah, last week I told you from Opa teaches Korean. For example, there's very famous Konglish is we call cider.
Ooh, cider.
Cider. Actually, we call we want Sprite or 7-Up from the restaurant, we call
Sprite or
Saida. Please give me Saida.
That's Konglish?
Yeah.
Oh.
Saida. But normally, Saida means a kind of the drinks, right?
Yes. Cider. Gassy drink.
In apple cider, like a...
Oh, apple cider, that's alcoholic drink.
Yeah. The cider means actually alcoholic drinks.
No, it doesn't mean alcoholic drinks, but it means gassy. Mm. Yeah. So, but of course, some cider, like apple cider, it is the alcoholic drink is gassy.
Yeah.
So cider means gassy. It doesn't have to be alcoholic.
Mm.
It can be like a gassy drink. It can be non-alcoholic too.
Oh.
Okay, I think we have enough. Between you and me, we have enough. Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Half baked, right? Make sure it's hard. Still have to be gentle with it, because if you use too much force, it will snap in two, since it's not fully baked yet. Okay. But this is what we're gonna do. The hole that we made with our broom. Take your this one. Hold the broomstick. Your olive. Okay. Your olive. Okay. And this one. Okay, you put it into the hole that you have made. Put it into the hole you have made.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And then you kind of pinch it close on top to fit the broomstick in. Okay?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay, it doesn't matter if you pinch it and it becomes very ugly, okay? It doesn't matter. So you just want to make sure that you join the broomstick to the broom handle itself. You still have to be quite gentle with it because it can be quite fragile, okay?
Okay.
That means cannot use too much force so far.
There.
Okay?
Mm.
Okay. Then the next part is this rectangular thing that you made
there
earlier on. Okay? Put it on top like that. Wrap it round the joining of the broomstick and the broom brush part that we make. Then you kind of press mold it in also this way, so it looks like that. Good job.
Thank you.
Okay, then.
Good teacher.
Good teacher, really.
Mm.
I tried to make it as easy to follow.
Yeah.
Okay. So now this part, we are going to take all these long strings that we make, right? We're going to do the bottom first. So far, watch.
Oh.
Okay. Everyone at home, you also see also. I don't start from the top here. I start from the bottom part of the brush. Okay. And I just kind of stick all the way until the tip. And then I break it off. Like this.
Try.
Yes, come, those at home, you try also. Okay, start from this part, the top part here. Okay, you can see. Start from the top part here, this way. It doesn't matter if it's a bit messy, okay? It's okay. And then you break it off at the bottom. How are you doing, Opa?
Am I doing good?
I can't see what you're doing. Yes, you're doing good.
Thank you.
Okay, make sure, right? Okay, come. I show yours to them. Okay, so you can see for Opa's one, right? These are his two lines. So he put them right next to each other. This is correct. It's good. Okay? So Opa, you continue taking all the string, then you start.
Okay.
Okay? All right. So it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if some of it is shorter than the other. So let's say after I cut this end, right, I only have this long more. It's okay. I just do it and then it can end halfway. It's fine also. Okay, some long, some short, that is fine. Okay, it will create some texture for your brush. So you do it round for the whole thing. Okay, so let's say if it's like, you just start from the top again. And then you kind of just go to the bottom. So it doesn't matter long or short. You just do it how you want to do. Just make sure you cover the whole brush that you have made. All right?
All right.
How are you doing, Opa?
Doing good. I hope so.
I hope you're doing good too. This is going to be displayed in our house.
Okay. I will do my best.
Then during the house party today, I'll tell everyone, look, this is what Opa made.
Okay.
Okay. He doesn't sound very enthusiastic about it. So this one you can do however you want to do, up to your own artistic ability. I found out that day from Opa, he told me, you said to me your what was it that you said to me? You were very good at sculpting in school.
I was, when I was P3 or P4, until the time I was, I really enjoyed
sculpting.
Oh.
So if you're good at sculpting, you will be good at this. This is, polymer clay is all about sculpting and...
True, yeah.
Yeah, so you should, you, not should be, but you should have an easier time with this actually. Okay, so I'm just basically just going from the top and then going to the bottom. It doesn't matter whether thick or thin. Okay, long or short, up to you. So how is this very similar to your sculpting in primary school?
Quite different.
Oh really?
What
do you sculpt with in primary school?
I made an elephant.
Oh, was it with air dry clay?
Oh yeah, correct.
Oh, this is also clay, but it's just oven baked clay though.
Mm.
So it's similar to air dry clay, it's just that it is oven baked only. Yeah, my broom is almost, oh my gosh, I've not even covered half of it yet. Do you have enough string, Opa?
1/4 I cover.
You covered 1/4?
Okay,
this part is the part that's a bit time consuming, so you might want to...
Tahan.
Yes, like Opa, like Opa said, you need to tahan a little bit. Okay. So you can do this. So you can see the brush that I'm doing. All right. So those that are following us at home, you try your best. If there's any questions, ask. Ooh, it sounds like the thunder sounds really loud now.
It must say nice and cute. Broom.
Nice and cute broom, right?
Thank you.
This is the season to make brooms.
Is it mine or her broom is cute? Which one? Yeah, whose broom is more cute?
Whose broom is more cute? Yours?
Oh.
Mine.
No, you didn't ask me.
Mine is cuter.
You see? But, yeah. The camera is keep taking only mine.
Hey!
Because mine is more better, right?
No! Mine is the cuter broom. How can yours be the cuter one?
Oops!
Oh, did you break it?
Distorting.
Is this distorting? Okay, this is why you have to be gentle with the broom, okay? Because if you are not gentle with it, it will distort.
Okay. It's like teaching or carrying a baby.
Hi, you're carrying baby, Are you sure or not? 5 months later, you have to carry, you know, far. What if you suddenly tell me, oh no, it feels like the baby is distorting. Oh. That's a problem.
Yeah, especially the head is distorting them.
No, Opa, you cannot anyhow do things like that. It's scary.
Scary.
Do you have enough, Opa? Is it enough string? We still have to cover the top, you know. That's why I ask you. That's why make sure you all roll out enough. If you all roll out extra, it's good. Okay? Extra is better than being short off.
Mm.
If not, then you have to stop this halfway and then continue rolling again. Okay? So this is... Ooh. It's starting to curve really funny. So, see, you can, it doesn't matter. I'm just kind of filling the gap, basically.
I only cover only less than half
oh,
so far.
really?
Oh,
I'm done with mine.
really?
Yes.
That's good.
Shall we help you with yours?
How can you help me?
To help you cover it. How are you doing? Oh, it looks nice though. Okay, yeah, you're a lot obviously better than me. I just like I'm just like covering it really quick. Opa's actually really, really detailed about it. He's still rolling it out. It's okay, Opa.
Can you wait for me?
I'll wait. Don't worry. We still have to cover the top.
Cover the top.
Yeah, there might not be enough time.
Can I switch only to half? Yeah.
Okay, for the right, I'm going to help Opa. Because we might be running out of time. Oh yeah. Okay. So I'm not as detailed as Opa. That's probably why he is taking a lot longer also. At home, right? You have the luxury of time, so it's fine. Okay. So you can just yeah. I'm just how do I say this? I'm just pulling it and breaking it accordingly. Yeah.
Just fill the gap.
Yeah, it's just filling the gap. So it doesn't really matter, like, because twigs are not all of even length and, you know. Okay, so I'm just filling the gap, basically. So for Opa also, because the bigger broom, that's probably why he's taking a it takes a longer time for him. Okay, so we are going to... I'm there.
Okay.
Yes. And then, so now it's quite loosely packed. Later, I'll press it down to kind of make it a bit more, make it stick together better. Okay. So, Opa, it's almost done already, yours.
Why are you so fast?
Because you are really meticulous in what you do. This is probably why you are good with sculpting when you are younger.
Yeah. Suddenly I'm very quiet when something makes it. Speechless.
Okay, so actually we might not have enough. Opa, can you roll out some more string?
Okay.
I don't think we have enough string. We need some more for the top later.
Okay. Amazingly, that it's first time for me to make this. It's quite stick each other very easily.
Yeah. So unbaked clay, right, tends to be quite sticky. Okay. So they will stick very easily to each other before baking. After baking, then it becomes very it's not sticky anymore. Okay. Roll another one, Opa. This is why we have to make sure that we have enough. Okay, and then this is the last part. Okay. How is it, Opa? It's done. Okay. So now, with another string,
there.
Okay, this top part here, this top part where we used to connect the brush and so this part, okay, we are going to cover it again, like that. So you start from the top. It doesn't matter if the joining is messy, okay, because we will cover it with the gold color clay later.
Oh.
Yeah. So you just join it. You just do the top. Okay. So from the top to the top part of the brush, from the top to the top part of the brush this way. Okay, so you just cover it. If the joining's a bit messy, it is okay. It doesn't matter. All right. How are you doing, Opa? He's doing okay. He's like, okay. So top to bottom. Opa, come show yours to the camera. Show how okay it is. Oh, it's going to rain soon. Is it raining at your at your place as well?
Will be cool.
It's been very, very hot these past few days.
Yeah, in the morning when I opened the window, it was very hot.
It's like hot air, right?
Mm.
And it was a bit hazy also. We stay in the east area. Maybe close to the sea, that's why. Okay. And then... How are you, Opa?
Fine, thank you, and you?
I am fine too. Are you sure you're doing fine?
Doing fine.
You are? Okay.
I hope so.
I hope you are too. Okay, I'm done.
Two-thirds done.
So it looks like that.
Two-thirds done.
Okay, very good.
Okay, so, what's next?
While Opa is doing his, I'm going to show you the next step. We're going to use this gold color clay here, okay? And we're going to make the bands. So if you see from this one, we're going to make these gold bands, all right? So you don't need a lot of gold clay, just a little bit. You take your cutter again. Make sure your cutter is clean, okay? Because you used to cut brown just now. Roll it into a small ball. Okay, then you're going to have a long one like that. If you have a roller or anything round and flat, okay, you can do that. You're just going to use it to flatten your gold clay. That's it. Okay. Actually, I think I didn't use enough gold clay. I have to use more. Opa, I'm going to help you cut yours too, okay?
Thank you.
Okay. So what we want is that band, so we want to make sure that it is long enough. Okay, and we're going to make it.
Yeah, Edmund said, Opa Broom looks like an interesting brush. Very detailed. Thank
very
you.
Detailed.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to take the cutter. We're going to cut it into rectangles, into a rectangle. Okay, so cut. Cut this way. Okay, so we need to make three bands. So we have one thin one, one medium one, and one thick one, okay? So since I'm cutting for Opa, it will be thin. Thin. Okay, actually that one's very thin. That one will be for me, the thinner one. Then will be a bit thicker. Okay, I don't have enough. Okay, and then we will have the thickest one for the top. Because one doesn't have to be long. Okay, because it will wrap around the top here.
Okay.
Okay, so just want to make sure that it is rectangular. Cut in half. Okay. Okay, this is a thicker one.
Mm.
Okay. So we're going to take the thickest one. Okay, we're going to wrap it round the top this way. That is your thicker one. So
covering the sticks and brushes.
And
right?
The top of the brush, yes.
Okay.
Okay, so it's going to be the stick and the top of the brush right there. Then if you are not happy with the joining, you can take your cutter and you can just blend it together. And then the joining will, it will join nicely. Okay. How are you, Opa?
Some particles are brushes.
Oh, I think it's better you to pick. But it's okay. Don't worry. If some of the gold got onto the other parts of the broom, it's fine. You can use your toothpick to kind of pick it out. All right. This is a bit more forgiving because it's all lines here. It's not a smooth surface. If it's a smooth surface, then it might be a bit more difficult. But because this has lots of texture to it, it's okay to just take a toothpick and kind of pick out the something that gets stuck to it.
Okay.
Okay. Next, we're going to take your medium one. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is yours. Okay, take the medium one. And then the joining between the top part of the brush, right? So there's this joining here. That's why I say it doesn't matter if it's messy. Okay, you're going to cover that part. So it's going to go round. Okay, so if this is too long, it's okay. You just take your cutter. You cut it. Okay. And then you're done already. Then for this hole there, you can just blend it together like this. Okay. Some people have blending tools at home. You can go and use your blending tool. But if you don't have, you can just use your cutter. It is fine. How? Opa's trying hard.
Yeah, very hard.
It's okay, Opa. It looks nice.
Okay.
Yeah, yours looks nice. It looks good.
Thank you.
Okay, before we put on the last band, you take your cutter, okay? You kind of cut some lines into the room. Into one direction this way, your brush is going down this way, right? So you're actually adding more texture to it. So you just kind of cut it however you want, okay? So it's actually adding a bit more texture to the brush itself. Okay? Opa, so gentle. Opa, you're being very gentle.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, it's fine. You can be gentle too. I wasn't very gentle about it, so I just got it.
Okay.
He's carrying a baby. Okay, he's happy with it. Once you're happy with it, the last one, the thin one. Okay, Opa, that's your thin one. This is my thin one. Okay, the thin one, you just put it slightly below. It should be around the thickest part or just before the thickest part of your brush. Cut away the excess. You use your blending tool or your cutter to just lightly do on top and then it will, the line will be blended together like that. Okay, that will look like this. Okay, so I'll leave Opa to his. Now, for those that are making the... Okay, Opa's trying his best. For those that are making the necklace, right? You take your eye pin now, so take the eye pin. Okay, you cut away the excess wire, the wire that you don't need. Okay, so like I said earlier, right? Last time... You fold it, fold the bottom bit of it so that it will create a mechanical bonding and it won't just slip. Because if you poke it straight in, after you pick, it'll come straight back out. So when you fold it in half like that, it will create a mechanical bond so that it won't just slip out. Okay? So you have your eye pin, which is like folded at the end like this. Okay? Then you look at your broom. All right. So I'm going, my necklace is going to hang this way and this way. So I need to poke my eye pin here. And then this is how I'm going to hang my necklace. You can thread a string, just get a string and thread it through. And then you can wear it as a necklace. Okay. Or you can put a chain to it. You just need to see my previous videos on how I did it. So then the broom is done already. How's your broom, Opa? You want to show them your finished project?
Yeah.
Okay. So then now we have to put it for another last round of baking. So this baking time will be a bit longer. Just now we put for 10 minutes for the big oven, right? Now you put in for half an hour. For 130 degrees. For this one here, okay, the small oven that we have, right? If you have a small toaster, you put it low or low to medium. Okay, and then after that, you low to medium, and then you bake it for about 8 minutes. Okay, depends on how hot your oven gets. Now, if 8 minutes is enough, okay, it's just to be on the safe side so it doesn't burn. Then you bake it for another, you take it out and then you bake it for another 2 minutes after you check. If you still feel that it's not fully baked. And then you just keep putting in and out until you get the correct timing. Once the correct clay for toaster, right? Then you don't need to do the in and out anymore. So let's say your toaster, it takes 14 minutes in total to bake it fully, right? Oh, you just bake it for 14 minutes.
Okay.
If you're unsure, I suggest you bake 8 minutes first, then get out, check. Not enough, you put in another 2 minutes again. Okay? So this is the end product. This is what we have baked, okay? So but we have finished for today. If there's any question, you let me know. And we will see you again next week. Next week, I will be doing, next week is November already.
Yes.
Yes. So November, right, I am going to do the, because it's Deepavali, right, and I do want to do some festival, like some very nice Indian design. So what I'm going to do last time, like the Chinese lanterns I made a sheet. We call it a polymer clay sheet, okay? So I am going to do a sheet again next week, and it's going to have some different colors. So my suggestion, I didn't bring any of the clays to show, but my suggestion is if you, for usually for Indian colors, a lot
purple.
Of gold, purple, peach green, royal blue. Okay, these are all the very nice colors that they use. Sometimes they have also very sparkly, they like very shiny things. So if you want to find clay that is a bit or like has a pearly shine to it, and I will take photos of it and show you what kind of colors you will need. But most of the time for Indian colors, they are never pastel. They are always very bright and very vivid colors.
Yes,
so if you stick to those colors, you will be quite safe. Get about 3 to 4 colors.
Okay?
So I will take photo, I'll post it on the group. Please go to the group, like the page, check, there'll be some updates there. Later on, there will be Opa class at 3 o'clock. And then at 4 o'clock, there is, is it the Chinese one? Nuren Wo Zui Fang, is it? Yes. Okay? So please do stay tuned. And then there's Wong Si Lai also later tonight, cooking. She does very nice home cooked food. Okay, so stay tuned, like our Aksphere page, do join us, you know, it looks like it's going to be raining, so indoors, stay dry, nothing to do, please come and watch our show, okay?
Okay. Bring an umbrella, please, if you go out.
Yes, stay dry, don't get sick, now it's not a good time to be sick. Okay, we'll see you guys later again. Bye!
Bye-bye!